Huntington, West Virginia, home of the Rose Garden of Ritter Park in Jones C. Edwards Stadium, the site for this game. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. UAB is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. He's to the 20, at the 30, and down he goes at the 33. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Quickly, Thompson gets him about 3 yards with a completion. Got his man, can't tack on any yardage. Knox gets the call. Nice run to the outside. He'll pick up a first down with that run from the halfback.
Solid 5-yard pickup. He was almost able to get to the secondary, but as it is, he still manages to move the sticks.
Caught, open field, and he's taken down at about the 49. It out to maybe the 43-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. He's out of bounds at the 39. The stop at the 30. Got a man, watch out here. He goes out of bounds. Right around the 28-yard line. Carries the ball for a nice gain. Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's tackled at the 17.
Well, they're living on the edge here a little bit, but you know, they're converting when they have to.
For a loss. From the 18-yard line, second down. He tackles him for a loss.
When this guy gets his arms around a ball carrier, I don't care who it is, he's not getting away.
Here's play number 14 of this drive.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Marshall is looking to go up by 3. Kicks up, and the field goal is good. They line up to kick this one away. From the 5-yard line. And he's taken down at the 28-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. They come out in an empty backfield. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. Second down and 16 to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. There's a strike complete. Tackle around the 31-yard line. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. Plenty of time in the pocket. He wants it all. Intercepted. Good job to pick that ball off.
He did a great job at getting in that passing lane and coming away with the ball.
From their own 28-yard line, it's first down. Marshall holds a field goal lead. Stopped in his tracks. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. He's got to throw it in a hurry. Slides down.
The quarterback thought he saw a little bit of running room, but he made a good decision to get down in a hurry.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. Gets to about the 34-yard line. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. Tackle made at the 36.
Here we go.
Just throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Fires to his tight end, nothing doing.
You know, he had his receiver open. He just put too much on that football. He's got to find a little bit more touch next time.
Greenwell is waiting for the snap. To the 40. He's taken down at the 44-yard line.
You talk about our meetings this week with the defensive coordinators, Kirk, and this is what they were hoping for, that they can control the line of scrimmage.
Well, these players must have been listening pretty intently, because that's exactly what we've seen. These defenses have come out. They've controlled things early, trying to just set the tone. It's really going to be up to both of these offenses to try to make some adjustments and try to be able to come after them in some way.
And he just gets rid of it. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Marshall has a 3-point lead. Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 47-yard line. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers.
fires that quickly, incomplete. Tackle at the 19.
Marshall's got people flying all over the field on defense right now.
Boy, they sure do. Right now, we're just seeing great defensive effort. They have a plan. They understand it. They're playing with great speed, and they're not giving up big plays. That's why they're playing well up to this point.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. And he's immediately tackled. Scrambling. Got the corner. And he's tackled
around the 37-yard line.
Man left, man left. Two down, two down. Let's go, let's go.
Throws and it's incomplete.
There's one the quarterback would like to rewind because he has a wide open receiver and he just misfires.
So it's third down now and they're going to need about four. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Catches it, and he's punished. Keaton, the return man. He fields the punt at the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Marshall is up a field goal. He's going to try and scramble. He's taken down around the 38-yard line. Tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down
at about the 39-yard line.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. Not a lot of offense in quarter number one, but nonetheless, we've got a close game. 3-0, Thundering Herd. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. They'll spread the field with five wide. He steps out around the 47-yard line. Quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense in alignment in a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
He's scrambling. Locked down at about the 35.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
First and 10, ball on the 20. Marshall is up by three. He's pushed out of bounds.
Right around the 18-yard line.
Couple of yards at most on that pass.
This junior wide receiver had absolutely no room to run after the catch. Good play by the defense.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Get him, get him.
halfback's got it. And he's taken down at the 10. Tailback on the screen. And they make the stop at the 5-yard line. He's on the run. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. He makes the PAT. An 11-play, 52-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 23.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down to the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
He's tackled at the 37-yard line.
Well, the quarterback's able to find a soft spot in the defense, and he threw an accurate ball for a solid pickup.
Gains his way to the 46-yard line. It out to maybe the 49-yard line. So the halfback takes the option and picks up the first down.
They didn't gain too much on the play, but they did get enough yardage to move the sticks.
They come out in a 5-wide set. He makes it to the 48-yard line. And now they're faced with another third and long as they try to convert and move those chains again. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up 5 wide. Pass complete and taken down immediately. The 19-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. He makes his way to about the 28. Receiver incomplete.
from their own 33-yard line. It's second down.
Tighten up, tighten up. Pull together.
Over the middle to his tailback. Tackle right around the 42-yard line. Scrambled. Decides to tuck it in. He's got space. And he hits him hard at the 46. Tackle made right around the 38-yard line. To the back and hit hard for a loss. Now he pitches it. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
Not over here. Not over here. Not over here.
They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. The kick is up, and it falls short. No good. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play.
Well, Kirk, good news. We saw him go to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, but apparently he's all right. It looks like he's going to get back in the action here.
They hand it off. Nice run there. Brown. Gets about 4 yards on the play. It's second and six. Ball on the 41-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's brought down in the open field. Field tackle.
Man left, man left. Three down. Let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
They push him out around the 24-yard line. Makes the first down catch.
That is not easy to stop. The quarterback hit his man on an out route, and the defender was in man coverage. As a defender in man coverage, you cannot get beat deep. And as a result, the underneath routes are going to be there. As you can see, it worked out great for the offense as they were looking for a new set of downs.
Quick throw. Nice play to set up first and goal.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
Let's go.
Touchdown, UAB!
A powerful push by the line and a really nice run. That'll get you into the end zone almost every time.
Trying to get within a field goal. They'll try the point after. And he tacks on the extra point. So that's a 7-play, 63-yard drive. And they get it in for 7. So our score, 10-7. UAB to kick this one off. Gathered in at the 6. He's out to the 30. Locked down at the 38.
A really defensive battle going on right now so far, Kirk.
Well, the defenses are flying around the football, doing a good job. I think both offenses are making it a little easier because of their style of game plan. I think if I were the offensive coordinator, I'd take a few chances. Be willing to open it up and try to give your quarterback a chance to make a play.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Now he's scrambling.
And he's going to come up with a sack.
The blitz was the call, but the D lineman was the one who made his way to the quarterback.
And he showed great quickness getting off the line into the backfield. This guy can move for a big fella.
Marshall holds a field goal lead. And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
From their own 31-yard line, it's third down. Kirk, good news. The guy that we saw go to the locker room with that injury earlier is back on the sideline, and I got to bet he's going to be back in the game soon. Slings it, and down he goes at the 38-yard line. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
Mitchell will be the return man. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out.
Has some daylight.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Right, running back's got it. And he's level at the 40.
Check, check. 98 Weasel. 98 Weasel. Here we go. Green 95. Green 95.
He lets it go. Nice catch. First down. He's knocked out.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. Taking back a yard.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Slings it out there, incomplete. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29. Quick throw, incomplete, Waters receiver. UAB is looking to tie things up. He gets it up, and this is no good. He didn't have the leg for it. That ball is going to be short. They can run this back. And he's tackled around the 19-yard line. So at the end of the half, Marshall leads 10-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. It's Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. I'm a fan of seeing guys one-step wrap, two-step squeeze, bring your feet, arrive with bad intentions. I don't want to take anything away from these defensive guys, David, but could this be that we're seeing a healthy dose of some pretty bad offense, too?
It goes hand in hand, doesn't it, Reese?
Sometimes,
pretty good defense makes, you know, average offenses look really, really bad. But, you know, when you have a great defense and you can take something away, especially the strength of the other offense, and make them do things that they don't do exceptionally well, and, you know, don't let them throw the fastball, make them throw the curve. And you see great defenses be able to do that all the time, and that's when you can be ultra-successful. You have to find ways to make people play, you know, the game out of their comfort zone.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He's to the 20. He got hit hard. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
He's taken down at the 31. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. He's going to try and scramble. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
They come up to the line here. It's second down and 14 after the sack. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. They come out on an empty backfield. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback.
It's a fumble.
And the ball bounces out of bounds. From their own 43-yard line. First down.
Did you see how he looked that ball into his hands? That's how you catch a football.
They'll bring him down at the 47.
Nothing doing that time. Defender stayed home, the blocking wasn't there, and down he went.
They'll line it up again on third down. Setting up blockers, your running back's got it on the screen. Brought down at the 50. Keaton is back deep to return the punt. He takes it in at the 14. Tackle made at the 20-yard line. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Marshall is up by three. And he's taken down at about the 19-yard line.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over to the sideline after the series. Make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play, that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
So the sack makes this third and very long. Here comes the pressure.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Mitchell takes it at the 47. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They'll spread the field with five wide. On the ground, left side. And he's tackled right away. The 39-yard line.
second down. Now he tries to buy some time. And they got him. That makes four sacks today.
Well, this speed is difficult to defend because you have to try to keep them off balance so they can't use their quickness.
Third and long now after the sack. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. UAB can tie it up here with this kick. It's up. And he just didn't have the leg for this one. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession. Marshall has a three-point lead. Going long. And they intercept it. The junior safety. And they make the stop at the 41.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at it. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
First and 10, ball on their own 41. He's gobbled up in the backfield. They come out in a five-wide set. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. He didn't throw it away under pressure, and it really cost him.
It sure did. He saw that he was going to get hit and just threw one up for grabs. He's got to learn to take the sack.
First and 10, ball on the 24-yard line. Completely stopped immediately. Marshall is up a field goal. Quick strike to the back, no good. Now it's third and six coming up. Ball on the 28-yard line. He's scrambling, decides to slide.
Good awareness by the defense to know where the first down was and stop him short of it.
Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. He's to the 40. He's taken down at the 41-yard line. I got to give this defense credit, Kirk.
Brad, I don't know what the heck's going on with this offense. They just haven't been able to come away with anything.
Offense comes back out looking to improve from their last effort.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
Steps out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. Around the 43-yard line. It's a carry left side. Tackle made
right around the 42-yard line.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
Greenwell is waiting for the snap. Room around the corner. Heaton takes it to 21. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
These offenses have just got to go back to the drawing board. Whatever the coordinators drew up this week clearly is not working right now. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Marshall holds a field goal lead. Fires to his fullback. No good. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 37. He scrambled. Tackle around the 38-yard line.
Job of picking up the Mike linebacker blitz and hitting his man for the first down.
He's tackled at about the 49. Couldn't get that additional yard he needed to keep the drive moving.
No, he was trying to muscle his way past those big guys, but they stood their ground.
They call on the kicker for a long field goal. That's three down and one to go. Marshall's got a three-point lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Up to this point, I wouldn't want to be an offensive coordinator in this game, but you know what? There's still time left.
There's still time left, and it's still a competitive game. As bad as these offenses have looked, if you can string together a play or two, maybe try to get in the field goal range, who knows, maybe a touchdown on the board, it could be the difference in the game.
So early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight football game, and the game could hinge on this possession. They've got their goal line set on the field. This might be a good time for some play action. And down he goes, around the 5-yard line.
Interception by the quarterback. Touchdown, Marshall. He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 30.
Marshall's defense has really been impressive, especially his last couple of drives.
Now you start to think about how this team has played defensively, and what it's done is set up their own offense with really good field position to give them a chance to be able to extend this lead.
So the offense will come back out onto the field, hoping for a little better result than that last pick six.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off of mistakes.
Makes it out to about the 46. Gets it out to him again. He's pushed out of bounds at the 47-yard line. Off. Here's an opening. The 10. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. So a great play by the defender to give his team 6 points.
That was a very good play, and that will certainly help build his team's momentum.
And he adds the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. From the 5-yard line, he's tackled at the 22-yard line. It's been a tough outing for this quarterback, Herbie.
Well, this is a defense's best opportunity to show what they can do to be able to dominate a football game. And if you're an offense, you might be able to move the ball, but if you're turning the ball over and you're having sacks on every other play, you just can't move the ball effectively.
He hasn't done much to silence the fans, but let's see if he can put something together here. It's going to be interesting now to see if this quarterback can put that last throw behind him.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off of mistakes.
And he's tackled at the 32. From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. Makes the grab and steps out right away. 117. And he's hit immediately. Taken down at the 43.
You ain't going nowhere. Let's go, let's go. We got Mike number 53. Mike 53. Check, check. Check.
Makes the catch and look out. He steps out around the 39-yard line. Knocked out of bounds around the 37-yard line.
Come on, come on. Let's go, let's go.
Nice run, and he's brought down. 4th down, and the offense is still on the field. The middle for a nice game. And we got an injured player on the field.
Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Mike two.
Five wide. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Brought down around the four-yard line. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Converts the extra point. Tackle made at the 40-yard line. So we're just about ready to return to action. Scrambling around. He gets sacked on the play. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30.
Three down. Mike six.
Shoot.
Screen, and he's taken down at the 36-yard line. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Kick is up, and it falls short. No good. Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Out of bounds at the 39. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on their own 39. And he's tackled right away. He's going to air it long. Tipped away.
You've got to admire the coverage for being able to deny the home run ball so cleanly.
From the 46-yard line, second down.
Let's go. Green and
quickly to the tailback. And they make the stop around the 28-yard line.
The defense might be licking their chops right now, Herbie. We've got a change at the quarterback position. We know the kid is talented, but you got to know the defense is going to come after it.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Steps up and goes down. Made around the 14-yard line.
Check. Hammerhead! Check. Hammerhead! Here we go! Green 19!
Throws quickly into the end zone, caught for the touchdown.
In the fourth quarter, and the big question is, in a game this close, who's going to crack first?
Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
Well, I think the play warranted a review, but the call on the field stands. And he tacks on the extra point. They'll bring him down at the 44.
This might be it. They've got the lead, but if they add to it, they know they've got a victory.
5-6. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Knox gains about 4 yards on the play. It's 2nd and 6. Ball on the 40. A little over a minute in the game. He makes it to the 38-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry.
This safety is as vicious a player as you're going to find. He will make the tackle every single time.
He's at the 30. He makes his way to about the 28. UAB will take their last timeout. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He takes a knee, looking to take some time off that clock. From the 30-yard line, second down.
Three down. Hey, check back six.
Man, black eight.
He'll go down to one knee. That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, 24-21, Marshall. So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.